Coming up at number 11,
which is my favorite.
This is a family. This is a family.
Trinity family.
Hey guys!
Welcome back to our channel.
I'm Irvin.
I'm Zuko.
And I'm Caesar. And this is a
Trinity! Away.
Not Trinidad. Trinity. But we could Trin your dad.
So, yeah. So today, Simandi is a great birthday. So, 11 to Kenny. Chonga. Sizi freshly squeezed.
Orange juice.
Thanks. It's okay, bye-bye.
So as you guys can see from the title in the description box, today's video is about gay code. We're going to be telling you guys a couple of things that we feel like every gay man or every gay guy should know.
Or any person that identifies
as gay should know. I'm sorry to everyone else, but this is just a gay video because... On this panel, there's only Instabanes, so...
I don't know what you're talking about, bro.
I know, me neither, bro.
Yeah, bro.
We should probably go, we should go chill with the Oaks.
Hey? Yeah, bro. Yeah, like, let's go.
Yeah, let's go to
this video is done.
Anyway. So gay code, and basically, we're not saying, like, this is the utmost gay code that people should know.
Yeah.
But we just saying we think that like if you identify as gay, like these are some of the things that you should know or
would like to know.
If you haven't.
We feel like it's stuff that we appreciate it.
Yeah.
Knowing, and we should just share the knowledge.
Anyway, and it's things that we've learned like during the course of our gay career.
Our gay career in this hard industry.
In this hard industry, like these are the few tips that you should probably know.
So it's 12 rules that every gay man should know by Trinity. And would you like to start, Caesar?
I'll give you the first one. So shout out to my bottoms. So guys, number one, please. Douche before a dick appointment.
Oh!
You need to
be
wash
clean.
That anus with like water and then jump up and down for like 20 seconds and then just
twerk
go.
And then twerk and then go upside down and then when you're done, just go to the bathroom and let it go.
Yeah, because so. Like, I mean, like, you don't want like some chocolate mousse.
I can't relate.
You can't be having a situation where you're intimate with your person or whoever's person
or your several peasants.
And then here you are out here and you're just like, something smells like nature.
And guys, like this is very important because you need to understand that like niggas out here now are buying like Egyptian cotton, white linen. Babes, you don't want to be that person who once the deeds is done, Tommy, you can't move.
Tommy, it's the Neb of the Kalahari Desert. It's just brown. Oh my lord.
And then at number two, we have. So here's. I really think this is like the most basic one. Like this is like 101. This is foundation phase type of shit that you should have learned in high school. Like you know how they taught you, like you don't speak to strangers. My nigga, if you don't wanna give me your number, then don't! Like, legit, guys, like, don't give out your number if you really don't want to chum me because what's the point? You're not gonna reply.
You're gonna block the person.
It's an exactly so. Why?
You know what? For me personally, I still give out my number to people nonetheless. But for me, I change. Like, oh, I shouldn't be saying this. But for me, is I changed the last few digits of my cell phone number so that even if I do give you my number, you might think that you put it in wrong so that I don't have to... I don't have to go through the whole thing of, oh, I'm speaking to Wadi Paul.
If you're not interested,
she strikes again.
What if that person keeps on trying the number and then just changes the last number every time. I mean, they only have 10 times.
They're not smart enough.
That's why I changed the last two digits.
Yeah, figure that out.
Figure that out.
Anyways, but yeah, if you're not interested, remember, just don't give out your number. Like, I just feel like it's okay to tell people that, okay, cool, I really don't think
you and I are compatible in
any way. It's not even about compatibility, Jim. It's just about, I just don't want to give you my number because I don't think you and I are going to speak or about something of substance, basically. So I would do that. So yeah, just don't do it.
Yeah. And in number three, every single time, 24/7, you should always have your friends' backs. So you can't say, now that you're in a different situation than you were like a week before, now you're going to be like, oh no, I can't handle certain situations that my friend is in. Or how is your friend supposed to deal with those situations if you are going to be like, friend, I can't help you.
You know, there are those people that try to infiltrate the whole squad. Yeah. Guys, don't let a penis penetrate your friendship.
Your friendship. Ever. Sure. And especially like with what Urban said, which makes so much sense, is really, it goes without say, guys, when there's a guy who's gonna try to infiltrate the entire group and try to act all, I can get all of you, and you let that shit happen.
Weak. Stronger. I see, but you are in your own.
Who my glock on? Who my glock hit? Who my? And number four, we have, don't ever tell your straight female friends who you think is gay. Don't do that.
Let's just say that one thing.
Don't do it. You're shooting yourself in the foot.
And to all my queens, guys, let me just tell you real quick. This is a rule that we should instill. Because our straight female friends have a tendency of falling or like having a crush on a guy, and we are quick to say, friend, he's gay. You know? And then kanti, the guy just has gay tendencies. He's a tutor after dark. And then the guy and your friend are hitting it off, and then no, 2 months later that guy's also hitting you up, and you just like, girl, I told you. I'm warning you.
But yeah, just don't ever tell your straight girl.
At number five, this is like, I don't know, like y'all might hate us for this one, but y'all, a nigga will always be a nigga.
Men are trash. And when we say hashtag men are trash, we are not excluding ourselves from that movement, because we know in our own capacities that there are people that are saying men are trash because of us. But that doesn't shy away from the fact that a nigga will always remain a nigga. So he's always gonna be loyal to his friends, just like most of us are. Yeah. And if a nigga's gonna lie to you, girl, you better make sure that that nigga's being creative at least.
Like, just don't be that dumbass nigga.
Yeah, don't be that one that's gonna roll over and
all of it.
And then in number six, we've got you, me, all of us. And I'm speaking to my queens now, and everyone else. We need to stop bottom shaming.
We
always are constantly judging bottoms for being bottoms.
Yeah.
And we're just like, oh my gosh, I can't believe you. That should need to stop. I mean, I feel like there's no better level of masculinity than being a guy who can take another guy. If you know what I mean. Okay. So can we stop bottom shaming, but also bottom, y'all need to stop doing shit.
We also thought that maybe we should incorporate educational aspect side as part of our gay code, and basically today we'll be speaking about PEP and PrEP. So yeah, grab a note, grab a pen if you want to jot this down.
So, we'll start with PrEP.
Yeah, so PrEP, basically PrEP is pre-exposure prophylactic.
Yes,
and basically it's a preventative measure. It's an additional preventative measure.
Yeah,
and basically, just like you know how condoms are a preventative measure for STIs, pregnancies,
STDs,
and all of that. So, PrEP is also a preventative measure for high-risk infections such as HIV and STDs and STIs. And so basically, so we just also wanted to touch on like a few facts about it. So basically, there is evidence that it works. So the South African National AIDS Council actually performed 12 clinical trials. And basically, they did this in Africa, in Asia, in Europe, and South America. And basically, it was proven that it actually does work, and which is why now it's been recommended. And yeah. So, and also, some of the misconceptions about PrEP that we thought maybe that we should highlight is that...
So that we can just try and also just eliminate the whole misconception idea and cloud over PrEP?
Yeah. So, PrEP does not necessarily mean you have to stop using condoms.
Yeah.
Bebek, no.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't. Well, it doesn't... It's not a drug that teaches you to not use condoms and tells you to not use condoms as a whole.
Yeah.
It's just a preventative measure.
On top of using a condom. On top of what you're preventing.
You're preventing in essence.
Yeah.
And also another misconception is that PrEP is just for gay men.
Or sex workers.
Yeah. Or men who sleep with men.
Yeah.
No, everyone.
Guys. PrEP is designed for everyone.
It's for everyone.
And
it's pre-exposure.
Yeah. And I mean, if it's medicine, how would the medicine know if you're gay, straight, or whatnot? It's going into
white,
your bloodstream.
Pepper, green, gray.
PEP stands for, it's an acronym that stands for post-exposure prophylactic.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Which means it's after the exposure of the virus or anything of that nature.
Not necessarily, like, even if you think that whoever, like, you babs, you're not just sure of their status and their sex life and their history and their past. So basically, you take PEP, which is post. Remember, PrEP is pre.
And then, exposure.
And then PEP is
it's
now post. Yeah.
Exposure.
So like now when you have reason to believe.
To believe that you have been infected or there's a chance of you contracting any virus. Even if it means as a doctor, if you were working on a patient and by chance you are exposed to anything of that nature, then the doctors would usually like would usually give you PEP. So that you can immediately like try to cleanse your system and your bloodstream.
Yeah.
So that
also, two very interesting facts about PEP is that you can take it 72 hours after the exposure or after like you feel like okay there's something that might have happened between yourself and your partner or significant other, and then also in the window period of like 28 days.
Mm.
And then something about PEP is that it also reduces the risk of you contracting HIV by 92%.
But
this must not make you happy and be like, oh, okay, you know what? Now I'm gonna, you know, do the deeds. I'm protecting myself.
Yeah,
guys, please, please, please always protect
yourself. To condomize regularly.
Safe sex.
Yeah, and I think from our side, like, one big tip that we'd like to give you guys, our
just
viewers.
The tip.
Oh, that never works, Jogi.
But this tip is gonna work.
Yeah, just the tip name. Basically, consistent condom use and one pill a day. Okay.
And coming in at number 7 is number 7. Stop asking the stupid question of who's top or who's bottom.
That
preference wise, can we just see that when we are actually in the bed?
Yeah.
Because like, I mean, you don't know if I'm gonna like it like this the first round, and then the next one I'm just like, okay, let the tables turn.
I think for me, like, So having those labels like sort of like restrict you in terms of the most ultimate sexual pleasures, guys. And also, like, I feel like we're in 2018. You're a man, I'm a man.
Let's just get this man sex happening.
Let's have this boy
let's
sex.
Let's have this boy sex happening. And let's not ask each other.
We'll see it when we get in there.
No, my babe, I'm African. And trust me, once you dip in this African butter, you're not gonna wanna dip anywhere else.
Number 8. Coming up at number 8. Y'all need to know how to read when you're being read.
Like, you need to know how to read
when you're being read.
And there's a difference between throwing shade and reading. Reading comes from throwing shade. Yeah. Okay. So when you're being shady, you are subliminally saying something about someone else. Mm. But when you're reading someone, it's when you're telling them facts.
Receipts.
Telling them.
Receipts.
Listen, honey.
Wait. Dragging someone. Mopping
you know, the floor with them. Because, like, reading is a matter of, yeah, it's entertaining, it's dramatic, and it's funny. And I would rather choose to be raped and reading someone than to actually be in a physical altercation. Because you know what? Like, when you read someone, you're just like, this person doesn't know the Cambridge English I've got in the bag. I'm gonna tell this person like it is.
Okay. All right.
And then,
number nine,
we've got, my babes, you gotta know your range. Don't be size up, no, no. If you're going
this
to try,
also very important.
If you're going to try to infiltrate into another lane, don't do it. No. You might find that there are traffic jams in that lane. There's some roadworks in that lane. Maybe there's no one in that lane, and here you are trying to occupy that lane. Know your range.
The important thing about knowing your range is that also you need to understand that in our community, how I'm referring to us gay people or anyone that identifies as gay, you need to understand that, babes, back corner, people that are great, relevant, established, that are there. And now you come with your student budget and you want to be here,
yeah.
But actually, you are not even.
Yeah, to me, not in the frame.
You're not even in this frame. You're not in this frame.
Akolana.
So it's important to understand your range when you're infiltrating friendships, when you're infiltrating DMs.
Guys, no,
your range,
no,
babes.
Your
range is important.
Range matters.
It matters. Beds of the same feather, beds of a feather flock together. Know your range. Find your flock, babes.
Find your birds.
Yeah. So coming up at number 10.
Number 10. Guys, I have to confess with number 10 there. It's written as the store. As in clicks. So I want to say.
As in the pharmaceutical store.
And so let's ask who wrote that. No, actually, we'll let you guys guess who wrote that.
Number 10 is that clicks do not work.
Yeah.
Guys, do you like gay clicks? Gay clicks do not work. Find yourself true friendships.
Yeah.
Clicks do not work.
Definitely.
Babes. But clicks does work, as in like the pharma store.
The pharma store? What?
The pharma store.
The person who wrote clicks with an S. You need to comment who you think it is in the description box. The person who wrote clicks with an S.
Do not be deceived.
Do not be deceived.
We all know the person.
Yeah, we do.
Okay.
Let's see if you do.
Let's see if you do. But but just to add on what you said, friend, about like with clicks and all of that, like basically we speaking from personal experience as well. Yes, maybe clicks might be working for you, but we rather say invest in true friendship, invest in lifelong friendship, invest in people who will always have your back, people who be your anchors, people who be your supporters and your biggest fans. Those work, not a click, because song is shele shampoo.
Yes. And also, we speak from experience, like just to touch on what Urban was saying, like we've had a lot of people who have claimed to be our friends and then turn
now?
Around and don't act like our friends.
Yeah.
Where are they now?
In the past, their history.
Who's there?
We don't even. They're dead. They're not
thank
exist.
You.
They never exist.
I don't know who they are.
I think my brain was washed, but yeah. Okay, cool. Coming up at number 11,
which is my favorite. Number 11, guys, is something that we were introduced to by one of our friends. And ever since that friend of ours introduced us to this issue and this topic, we've been literally obsessed with it. Like, we have catchphrases from this. We have certain actions that we do that is from this. And that is the ballroom scene. Now, guys, if you don't know what the ballroom scene is, you need to Google. No, actually, on a YouTube.
Yeah.
On a YouTube, you must go on a YouTube, and then you search in a YouTube the ballroom scene or Paradise or Paris is burning.
Yeah, it's from the movie Paris is Burning. We're not gonna
more of like a documentary.
We're not gonna get into it because that's your homework.
Yeah.
But yeah.
All we can say, darling, is opulence, darling. Opulence.
Opulence. You own everything,
babe. You own everything.
Opulence. So yeah, that's gate code number 11, guys. Familiarize yourself with the ballroom scene.
Yeah.
And coming up at number 12, drum roll. Damn. Okay, guys. This may be a debate. You may agree, you may not agree, you may concur, which means agree as well.
Which we did disclaim at the beginning of this video that these rules are rules that we feel that
of our views.
We've gathered with our time being friends and all of that, and we feel like everyone should know them, or if everyone wants to know them, they can.
So, yeah, coming up at number 12 and the last gay code, basically, guys, let's be honest, guys. You know how we all know Chuck Norris, or Rambo. No one can say you don't know who Jet Li is,
or Rambo, Terminator.
Terminator. Mm. Or Van Damme. Because those were relatable movies, and now we feel that as part of the gay code, the most relatable movies that you should know.
Without a doubt.
In this day and age, it's definitely... What's the first one?
Mean Girls! The original one! Hey!
She doesn't even go here!
On Wednesdays, we wear pink.
That is so bitch. What is bitch? Bitch is not a thing!
And
the second movie
is The Devil Wears Prada. Oh.
First of all, let me grab the title.
Miranda.
That's all. And that's all from us with our 12 rules for being gay and gay code.
So thank you for
watching. Thank you guys so much for watching. It was every time that we shoot one of these videos and every time that we get to sit down and talk to you guys, it's always so much fun because we get so excited to like speak to you guys.
And inside both.
And it's just so lovely having you guys like come into our lives and like understand and like sit in and join the conversation and, you know, relate to some of the stuff that we talk about.
Yeah.
And yeah, we just really, really appreciate the support and the love. And yeah, give this video a thumbs up.
You know, remember to like, share, subscribe, tell your friend, to tell a friend, to tell a neighbor, like you know, all of the above. Bye.
Bye.